Hello and welcome to watch this video about Digitalisation, Computing and Electronics Bachelor degree at the University of Oulu. Today we are going to talk about Electronics and Communication Engineering track of this study program. And I have two dear guests with me, which are experts in this field. I'm Goharshad, your host, and let's start with a brief introduction. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Marko Neitola, and I am working in the Circuits and Systems unit, and I'm currently a teacher tutor for many of our DICE students.
Thank you and welcome.
Thank you, Goharshad. I'm Aprotim Paul. I'm studying my second year in the Electronics and Communication degree program in DICE, and I'm the international representative for my guild as well.
Thank you. Welcome again. I'm really excited to hear about the study program. And let's start with Paul. Can you share your story, how you ended up studying in the program and at the University of Oulu?
Very good question. Since my childhood, I was pretty much interested into electronics and machines. I used to tinker with them quite a lot. And I think that's what kind of led me or pushed me to study electronics. So while researching, in my high school, final years of high school, I actually wanted to get an exceptional experience, not a degree, basically. And Oulu stood up for me in every sense, the weather, the climate, the education, the research facility. So I think that's how I ended up here in Oulu, in the, well, cold north, amazing place.
That's fascinating. I really liked the keyword experience, and I would like to ask Marko about what are the main experiences and expertise that this degree is offering students?
Yes, our bachelor studies in Electronics and Communications Engineering, or ECE, contain 3 years of basic and intermediate studies that prepare students for 5 different study options. So that is 5 different branches that they can choose. So in their master studies. So these study options are electronics design, electronics materials and components, future electronics and measurements techniques, radio engineering and radio access networks. So overall, we have 5 different focuses, and these are affiliated with 5 different research units under ITEE faculty.
That's really interesting to have so many options. Mm-hmm. I'm curious that students from which background are attending this program. Paul, can you share about your background a little bit?
Right. Thank you, Goharshad. Basically, I studied in the science track in Bangladesh out of the 3 tracks we are offered in high school. And I took my courses, for example, advanced mathematics, advanced physics, which led my foundation for the degree here. And I believe that whatever I studied there for the science track related to the first year studies of my degree here, which made the experience a bit smoother, I would say.
Nice. But all students are having this kind of expertise, or it's possible that different backgrounds can contribute to the program?
Of course, and there are many different backgrounds for our international bachelor students in general, but our students, they are truly culturally diverse, but we do have standards for to ensure that our students are up to the task. So first and foremost, English and math skills, they are extremely important in our new bachelor students.
Thank you. That's really highlight point. Mm-hmm. Talking about English proficiency, let's move on to the application process. What have you done for applying to the university? What were the steps?
You asked me one of the questions in the beginning, why did I apply to University of Oulu? The another reason I didn't tell you was the application process. I did apply to a lot of universities during my last year of high school, and I think application to Finland, or specifically University of Oulu, was one of the smoothest for me. I had to submit my academic grades, I had to submit my IELTS result for English proficiency and my SATs, and that was it. I clicked submit, basically. That was the most smoothest and streamlined process I have ever had in my application process, I would say. So that was quite it.
I really agree. When I was applying to my program, I had a really smooth experience as well.
Indeed.
Marko, can you give a little bit of tips to our future applicants to help them?
Survival tips. Well, people skills are important in any new school, on a university or institution. So during your studies, you need to make new friends, new networks. That is very important. If that is something that is not very easy for a person, I would recommend just to take bravely steps out of your comfort zone. It's always worth the effort. And the second one is get to know your new environment. Focus on orientation. You may find that our teaching culture may be less formal. So for instance, you can actually talk to professors. And at the times of confusion, always look close for support. Often our study-related issues are solved by consulting the teacher that is teaching the course. And our university also has many sources of support for various study life problems and issues, so they are very close to you. And a final tip, keep your parents in the loop, but don't worry them too much. Thank you.
Yeah, these are really points that can touch our heart, because we have experienced really related to these points. Before moving to the coursework, I would like to add something about the application process. You always can find updated info about the application process and steps that you need to take on the website in study info. After applying and getting here, finally, you had to take some courses, obviously. Can you share about what kind of courses you had, and if is there any interesting thing about delivery method and teaching tools?
Okay, thank you for the question. As Marko actually mentioned, that the teaching method here is quite different from what we experience in other countries, or even in high school, I would say, for me at least. So there, it's totally different than high school in the sense that there is no pressure for you to learn. It's up to you technically. So you have to excel, or you have to have a self-motivation to study what you're studying. And for the courses, we had quite a bit of interesting courses in the first year. Apart from the heavily dependent math courses like calculus, differential equations and everything, we had some electronics courses where we learned hands-on tools to design a PCB to manufacture it in the fab lab at the university. Those are really very interesting courses, I would say, that one can have in their first year, making an actual electronic circuit, printing it, testing it. So I would say it's really an interesting course that people will have if they consider studying electronics here.
Mm-hmm. Overall, are students having many hands-on experiences? Are they doing many projects?
Well, they are open to new projects, but well, the first year, some students complain about them being just a math-oriented first year, but there's a reason for that, and the interest in intermediate courses start at second year. And well, talking about first year experience, it is so much more than that's just studying. Our orientation is deeply connected to get our student networks started. Our new students have a student tutor who is familiar with studying life, and they can guide our students to activities, guild activities, hobbies, and even electronics club.
It's really interesting that you're supporting students in many ways, even networking. And is this networking being continued after graduation about job seeking situation? What's your opinion?
Well, students are very active in, well, we do have a career center in university, so they offer many tools and basic information how to maintain networking, how to be in LinkedIn, how to optimize everything related to job hunting and being in working life.
Yeah, and what are job possibilities for graduates of this program?
Oh, we have such a range of specializations. So basically, ECE program answers widely on what the current demand for electronics and ICT companies have in Finland and, of course, internationally. The range of expertise is vast, and typical graduate profiles are electronics designer, system designer, testing engineer, project manager, specialist, research scientist, postdocs, and of course there can be like a lecturers in the academic path.
Mm-hmm. So from my understanding, it's a really in-demand area.
Yes.
And you have so many options. Do you already considering something?
Well, like he said, this degree is a very broad discipline, and there are many ways you can go to. And at the moment, I'm working as a research assistant at the university, and I really like this niche of the academia and the research. But industry is a very interesting option to explore it, and I will be exploring industry options as well in my coming years. But at the moment, I'm really in the mood for exploring all the options, like you mentioned. So I'll see where my degree takes me.
All the best for your journey, and thank you for being us today. It was really
very much
interesting conversation for me, and I hope that it would be for our viewers as well. You can always find more information about degree programs on our website, oulu.fi. Thank you.